So let's come back to our train.
We haven't done much with this data set.
Okay. But this is a very interesting data set.
Hmm.
So what we said is that every train goes through some stations.
Correct, correct. Yeah.
So a train in some sense is a sequence of stations or a list.
It's a list of stations. Train seems to be a list of stations.
And then for instance, if you want to know what happens at Kharagpur,
that's a station.
We can
that's
go
a
to
list
the
of trains.
And then we can look up Kharagpur in this list, for instance.
Hmm.
And it will give us a list of trains.
So it looks like this is a dictionary. Because you know, this is a list of items, each of which indexes into a dictionary.
This, yeah. So this is like a dictionary.
This is one dictionary and this is another dictionary.
Yes.
Looks like to me.
Yeah. So these are the keys. The train number
is the key.
Or the station name.
So what we have are two dictionaries here.
Yes.
Right? This is one dictionary. Dictionary which is indexed by
the train
number.
And
this is a dictionary indexed by the
train station name. And from here we get entries here.
The train itself is a list of
entries into this
dictionary. And this one itself, each station, a list of entries into this dictionary.
Correct.
So what we have is, I mean, maybe you should draw it. It looks like an interesting thing. You have two dictionaries.
Yes.
Each one is a list. Each one entry has a list.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
List of entries into the other one. And that one has a list of entries into this one.
Correct.
So mutually linked.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. And we can go back and forth.
You can go back and forth.
Yes.
From a train, you can go to station. Station, you can go to train.
Yeah.
Like that. Back and forth.
Yeah. So let's see if we can use that information. So we saw last time how to check whether you can go directly from one station to another.
We saw that, yeah.
Right? So we said that we will take the starting station. Supposing we were, I forget where we started from, but supposing we were starting
Chennai
from
Chennai to Bhubaneswar, something like that.
Yeah, some Chennai to Bhubaneswar. Then we start with Chennai's card, look at the trains that Chennai is connected to. And for each of those trains, we see Bhubaneswar appears on that list.
On that list.
If so, that is a direct train from Chennai.
So what we are doing is we are taking Chennai station. We know that Chennai is an index into this dictionary.
Yes.
So you go to that particular index element.
Yeah.
That is storing a list,
yes.
List of trains.
And for each train, we index,
you know,
into
this dictionary.
And look up which stations it goes to.
Which station, that again is a list.
Yeah, and Chennai will be one of them because we know that its
train
passes through Chennai.
So you want to see whether in that list there is Bhubaneswar.
Yes.
If that Bhubaneswar does not occur in that list, discard it and go back to the next train.
Yes.
Keep on doing that till you find the train which has a list. If there is no train, then you will find at the end of this process, you will find
that for every entry in the Chennai dictionary, there is in the Chennai list, there is, the train doesn't pass through Bhubaneswar. Then we can't go directly.
Can't go directly.
Right.
Which case we have to?
So now, so the obvious next step is, can we go by changing one train?
Changing one train is, we discuss again, this idea of a junction.
Yeah, so we have to go to a station where
which has
two different crossings, yes.
Like that, right? So basically, it seems that the train has neighboring stations.
Which are different.
We did that, right? We did that exercise. I don't know, we found some interesting.
Yeah.
We looked at some interesting ones, like Kharagpur, I don't know. Some of them we saw.
Yeah. So now let's try to see, for instance, whether we can go from Mangalore to Pune.
Mangalore to Pune?
So
I doubt that there is a direct train.
So first let's check with that direct train. So here I find Mangalore. So Mangalore has got now these four trains.
So you indexed, what did you do? You indexed into this.
Indexed into this and I got Mangalore.
Picked up the Mangalore list.
Yes.
This is a list.
Okay.
Now you're going to read out one by one in that list.
Yeah, and then you will index into that.
So
I start with 02283. So that's the first train.
That is the first train. So I'm going into this dictionary and picking out 02283, right?
Yes.
Which is this one, right?
Yeah. And now we go down that list.
So this is a list again, list of stations.
Yeah. And we see if Pune is one of them, and it is not there.
Okay.
So 02283 doesn't take us to Pune.
Okay.
The next train is 12224. 12224.
12222. 4. Okay. I guess the computer will go directly, we are searching, but it will go directly to this card.
Yes.
Okay. So 12224. And this again is a list.
Yes. And again it has Mangalore because we started in Mangalore. But there is no Pune.
There is no Pune.
So these first two don't pass through.
And
of course the other trains are, we said that they're in pairs. So if you look at 02284, it will be the opposite direction of 2283 normally.
So you don't need to really check it, but anyway, let's do that.
So just we can check it just
to make sure. Yeah. So this is 2284.
Yeah, so it's going from Delhi to Ernakulam, whereas the other one was going Ernakulam.
And again, Pune doesn't occur on this.
And finally, 1223.
1223. Which is this train.
Yes.
So this again is going Mumbai to Ernakulam, opposite direction.
Yeah.
And Mangalore appears, of course, but no Pune.
So we know we can't go. So now the question is, can we somehow change trains somewhere and go via a changed train?
Mumbai seems to be the place. We don't know. Okay, we'll find out.
So what we are saying is that we can go, can we go from Mangalore?
Sorry, Mangalore.
Mangalore.
To Pune.
So we want to first go somewhere.
Junction.
Which will be a junction. And then from that junction, we want to go to Pune. Is it possible to do this? This is what we are asking.
The dumb way of doing it is that you find from Mangalore where all you can go.
Yes. Yeah.
Right?
So that we can do, right? For each of these trains, so we have this.
Where all you can go.
Yeah, so we have
this. But we don't need everywhere because we need only junctions. But anyway, we'll find out first where all we can go.
So if you take this train, for instance, then it gives us a list of
places
we can go. So I have a list of places. And if I take the next train, then I have another list. So these are all the places I can reach
from Mangalore.
From Mangalore.
I collect all this together in one list.
Yeah. And then from each of these, I'll have to check again by looking at all the trains that pass through that station.
Too much. I don't want to do that. I'll do that I do the same thing for Pune now. Why don't we do the same thing for Pune? This time I do the other way, but.
Yeah, that's because we know that these trains actually are matching.
Even if they don't match, I can find out all the trains which enter into Pune.
Coming from the opposite direction.
That we know.
Okay. So we can do that. Okay. So let's do that. So we start with the Mangalore list. So we have one list. So we will.
Let's find all the train stations you can reach. Ideally, we want to only find all the junctions we need. Let's find all the stations first.
Yeah. So we have Pune now. So Pune has more trains. So we will have to look at each of these trains and see where all you can go.
Which all trains will get you to Pune? You want to see?
Yeah, which all trains will get us to Pune? These are all the trains passing through Pune.
Passing through Pune.
So we have to find out from where all you can enter Pune.
Pune. Okay.
So, but we don't know which direction we are coming from. So let's just take all the stations you can reach.
Let's see all the stations. Let's do a list of stations.
So should we first write down the list of stations from Mangalore?
Let's go do
Mangalore. So let's go back to this 02283 and write down all those stations.
02283.
Yeah.
Okay. So here is 02283.
Okay. So
I'll make a list.
Yeah. So I'll just write it down. So Mangalore.
So presumably you should look only after Mangalore, no? Because it's Ernakulam, Kozhikode, Mangalore, so only afterwards. So only trains which are after Mangalore in this list.
Okay. Right. So
Madgaon.
Okay.
Ratnagiri. Mumbai. Vadodara, Baroda.
Yeah.
Ratlam. Kota.
Yeah.
New Delhi.
Yeah.
And Kolkata.
Kolkata? Wow.
This is a crazy train, huh?
Yeah. Can't we go to Kolkata? I think there's some mistake there, I think.
It's 1916. It's wrong, no?
Yeah. So I think it must be going into Delhi. So let's assume that's wrong.
Yeah.
Because if you look at this train, the pairing train starts at New Delhi. So I think that entry for Kolkata is probably wrong.
It's wrong. Okay.
Okay.
This is an error. Okay. You found an error in the card. Sanity check. Type checking. Okay. So it ends in New Delhi, I think.
New Delhi. And 02284, which is the third train, you can see that the same stations are there in reverse order. So we don't have to write again.
Yeah.
So this was the first train. So this was this basically
02284 is the same station.
83 and 02284. So we don't have to make a second list. And then we have the other pair, which is 1221.
Though, of course, this thing tells you, this is important because this tells you can go from Mangalore to Kozhikode and Ernakulam.
Yes. You can.
In that sense, you can.
Yeah. So maybe we should write all the stations, right?
You should write Kozhikode and Ernakulam.
Okay. So let's just add that here.
you can go from Mangalore to Kozhikode aircraft using this 2284 train.
Yeah.
Though I don't know whether from Ernakulam you can reach Pune, but anyway, find out. Okay. So we have,
all these stations which you can reach by these two trains from Mangalore, and this is other pair 1223.
1223. And what is the pair for that?
1224.
All right. So
this is a shorter, shorter route.
You want to keep it in order.
Yeah.
Okay. So here we have the two trains. Two, three,
so again, they start at the same place. So Ernakulam is already there. Kozhikode is already there. Mangalore is already there. Madgaon is already there. Ratnagiri. So actually, this is a subset of the other one because we have Ernakulam, Kozhikode, then Mangalore itself, of course, Madgaon, Ratnagiri and Mumbai.
Okay.
So we don't get any new stations.
We don't get new stations.
This doesn't help us. So now we know where we can go. So this is basically.
You've done the Mangalore.
Yeah. So I will just put a tick here saying that we have got no new information. But we could have written out the list and done that. So now we go to Pune.
Okay.
And we want to do a similar exercise for Pune. Right. So we do, I think the pair is 12219. And 12220. So 12219 and 20.
Okay. So here are the two trains, 19 and 20.
Yeah.
So
Secunderabad, depending on which one we are looking at first.
Mm.
So Secunderabad, Solapur.
Solapur, Mumbai. Okay.
Okay.
Doesn't help because I think none of those are common with that.
Well, Mumbai is there actually.
Oh, Mumbai. Oh, so okay. So you found
something. But let's continue and do the whole thing. So maybe there's more than one way because we might want to find a better way or so on.
So, you're going from.
So you are going from Mumbai. Yeah, Mangalore to Mumbai.
Mangalore to Mumbai.
And then from Mumbai to Pune.
Using the Ernakulam train. Ernakulam Mumbai train.
Yes.
And then Mumbai Pune using the Mumbai Secunderabad train.
Yes. All right. So that's one way to
go. One way to go.
Okay. And then we have 122 next two, 21 and 22.
2100, okay. All right. So this is Pune to Kolkata.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. So you have
Daun, Manmad,
okay,
Bhusawal, Nagpur, yeah, Bilaspur.
So this is going in the wrong direction. So
I don't think it's going anywhere. Tata Nagar, Kolkata. Kolkata.
Okay. So this is not very useful to go.
And the same stations in the other direction. So yeah, we don't need to write the station again. So this is no use because it's not.
Yeah. Geographically it's going in the wrong
direction. Yeah.
And then we have 12264.
12264. All right.
And
63, I think.
Yeah? 63. Yeah. Right.
This is Pune to New Delhi.
Okay. This may be.
Not likely. Huh?
Not likely, I think. Let's see.
Let's see. Pune. Mm-hmm. So Lonavala.
Okay.
Mumbai. Oh, coming to Mumbai.
Okay.
Vadodara. Ratlam.
Okay. So there are all these stations which are in common. Now it's following Kota, the same route as that one. Vadodara, Kota, Ratlam.
Kota, New Delhi. And the other direction is the same. Same stations.
Okay. Okay.
So what do we find?
So we find that basically this route is following the first route. Beyond Mumbai, if you remember, it continued to New Delhi. So, we have Mumbai, Vadodara, Ratlam, Kota, New Delhi. So, all of these
are potentially possible
potentially
junctions
places that you can.
Huh? Yes. But you will actually come back. It's not a very efficient.
Yeah, because you will go along the same route and come back.
Come back again.
So, Mumbai is probably the best place,
to change.
Yeah. And there is one more train if you just want to look at that as the last one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, 1229798.
Okay. Let me put this back. 6364. 97.
Yeah.
97 and 98. Okay. 97.
Yeah. So this is a short one. Ahmedabad.
Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Lonavala, Pune. Mumbai is there.
Yeah. So you can see. Yeah. So we've actually repeated some of these, but so the important thing is that we have found that there are these common ones. So Mumbai is one,
Yeah.
And of course, these are also common, Vadodara, Ratlam, Kota, New Delhi. But that's because they're really in the same direction.
Okay.
So ideally, one would go to Mumbai. Hmm. But what we have saved is by approaching this problem from the two sides.
Hmm. Right? Hmm.
So instead of what we would have done otherwise, is look at Madgaon,
hmm.
look at all the trains in Madgaon, and see from each of them, does it go to Pune?
Hmm.
If not, then we go to Ratnagiri, then check all the trains in Ratnagiri, take all the stations.
That will take too much time.
So that will be like a nested iteration, right? We are doing for every train station that I can reach from Mangalore, you are saying what are the stations you can reach from there and does that include Pune? Whereas here we are just doing
both sides,
two
ends.
Yeah, two iterations, one after the other. One, all the trains in Mangalore, and then all the trains in Pune.
Speaking, you should find all the junctions in Mangalore.
Yeah, so that would have been more reduced.
Maybe then we would remove. See, for example, this Vadodara, Ratlam, and all may not be junctions. I don't know whether they're junctions or not.
Probably not.
But they may have gone away, and only Mumbai would have been left.
Yeah, and even something like Sholapur may not be
a junction. So it would have come out. And we'd be left with a much smaller number of stations.
And
so you can compare
to compare this list to this list, we would have had a
fewer things to compare.
Fewer things to compare.